In this video, we're going to expand upon telling a story with generative design using the data available to us. In a previous example, we used the curtain wall optioneering Dynamo graph to visualize this in another software. The software that we used was Power BI, and this made use of the outcomes exported from the generative design tool. For that workflow, we did run a randomization routine. So we exported the outcomes and the thumbnails and visualized those. As you may remember, we previewed the thumbnails, we added selections for those, we added unique versus total number as a graph, and we have a little window down here that visualizes them as well. The link to that post is below, but we want to expand upon this. In addition to exporting outcomes in generative design, we are able to export discarded options. In this example, we exported ones that were optimal. Now we're going to explore how to export every outcome possible. So we're going to go ahead and do that now. For this example, I'm using a version of Dynamo called Dynamo Sandbox. Dynamo Sandbox is available as a standalone install to be able to run it without Revit or any other software. That being said, this example will run perfectly fine in Dynamo for Revit and Generative Design for Revit. For this example, what we're going to go ahead and do is navigate to the Generative Design tab in Dynamo and navigate to Create Study. In this case, we are going to use the sample files. We're going to go ahead and take a look at the sample titled 3-box massing. The reason this example is being used is because it optimizes for 2 pieces of criteria, resulting in a multi-objective optimization. To further expand upon that thought, multi-objective optimization is defined in the generative primer. The generative design primer is available at generativedesign.org. Within the objective function chapter of the primer, we can see multi-objective optimization. In this case, and we'll make this a little bit larger, you will see that we have an objective to minimize on the y-axis of this chart and an objective to minimize on the x-axis of this chart. All of the plotted points within the chart represent unique solutions. In the case of these red solutions, or these red plotted points, we will see that those are less than ideal. The yellow plotted points represent points that satisfy both objectives. The blue plotted points represent ideal conditions. So if we're optimizing towards 2 criteria, this bottom left point would be amazing. Unfortunately, it doesn't solve some of the other criteria as well, so we'll tend to stay on this clustering. We'll see that clustering mirrored within the sample that we're going to run. Back in Dynamo, we'll go ahead and create a study from this 3-box massing. In our case, we'll use the default values that are in here, and we'll go ahead and click on Generate. Once our run's complete, we will see that we have several results available to us. In this specific example, we're creating 3 massing objects targeting a maximum floor area but minimum surface area on the outside. In this case, we can click on any of these options and explore it further, as you may be familiar with. Looking at the scatter plot, we can start to see how some of these pieces of data correlate. In the case of the options being shown to us in the preview, these are ones that are ideal. By default, in generative design, we are going to show you options that work. This is where part 2 of this process comes into play. Selecting the ellipses button option on that current study, we are able to export the outcomes. In this case, we want to export all generated and discarded outcomes. This is really important because we can really start to tell this story of this generative design workflow within Power BI. To make it a little more interesting, we're going to include the thumbnails. Go ahead and click on Export. Once the Export dialog opens, you will notice that you have to pick a path to export this zip file. In my case, I have a folder saved on my OneDrive. I'm going to save it there, and we'll click Save. You will get a notification that the file was successfully created. We can go ahead and open that now in File Explorer. In the case of this file, we do need to unzip this file. I tend to use a software called 7-Zip for this, but you should be able to click Extract All as well. Once this is extracted, you will see that you have every thumbnail available to us and there are a whole lot more thumbnails than we saw in the generative design window. In addition to these thumbnails, we have a CSV file with the data that corresponds to each thumbnail. We can expand this a little and we'll see that we have headers as well. By default, generative design will place the study name, the study type, the creation time, the method it used, and everything at the top line. For Power BI, we don't need these first two lines. So we'll go ahead and select those and delete them. In addition to this, we want to go ahead and insert another column. By default, generative design uses the unique ID of each solution to map that to. But as you can tell, this unique ID is very long and not very user-friendly. So what I like to do is I'll insert another column. I'll give it a header of option. And I like to assign these options in this way. So if we scroll down, we'll see how many we have in here. We have 618 solutions in here. So what we'll do is we'll go ahead and type option 001. Next line, we'll type option 002. And if we select the first two rows, it will go through a number as we scroll to the end. That's a quick way to number things. There are more than likely several other ways to do this in Excel, but this isn't an Excel tutorial. And with that complete, we have all of our option numbers in place. Now what we'll do is we'll go ahead and click on save. We'll close the CSV file, and we need to do a couple of additional steps. For Power BI, these thumbnails have to live somewhere. They need to live on a publicly available website to be able to upload them. The easiest way to do this is to use a website called GitHub. GitHub is a platform to build and create code on. Dynamo's actually built on GitHub and fully open source, but it allows us to upload images to create a publicly accessible URL. This is something we did in the previous tutorial, so this is more of a recap at this point. All right, so this is my GitHub landing page, if you will. In order to get this done, we're going to go ahead and click on New Repository. We're going to name it Generative Thumbnails. You can name this whatever you want, and we'll name it 3box. You want to make sure it's public. We're going to allow it to add a README. That way it has an area for us to upload images, and we'll click Create Repository. With that created, we can click on Code, and we see this landing page. At this point, this is a public repository for code or data, so you can always take a look at this example for reference. I will include the link below for this repository. In the case of uploading thumbnails, it is a drag and drop process. It's another really nice thing with GitHub. However, you are limited to a certain amount. What we'll do is we'll go ahead and we'll tile our windows a little bit. So for GitHub, you are limited to 100 at a time. So we will just grab these images in chunks of 100, get them uploaded, and then we'll map these in the Excel file to the related unique ID. Each time you finish a chunk of 100, you need to click Commit Changes. For our Revit users, this is kind of like a sync with Central. This allows us to upload those changes to GitHub. At this point, I'll go ahead and upload the rest of the files, and we'll just clip to the next step when we map these files. With that complete, the next step of the process is to add our thumbnail URLs to our Excel file for use in Power BI. In this case, there is an included Dynamo graph for this sample called Add Thumbnail URLs. Go ahead and download that and you can follow along. The inputs for this Dynamo graph are as follows. We need your GitHub URL, so the URL that you copied to your keyboard will be the one that we use. In this case, this is mine, so we'll paste it, and we need to remove the last portion of this URL. This is the unique ID of that image that we viewed. The second input would be where we want to write our Excel file. In my case, I'll write it to my outside directory of my export. You can write this wherever you'd like. The next input, we need to pick our CSV file that came out of generative design. In my case, inside of my 3box massing folder, I have a 3box massing 003.csv. Other than that, this graph will just run, so we can go in and click on Run. And you will see Excel open, and you will start to see the thumbnails parameter filled out on the last column. These thumbnails map to thumbnails that are available on our GitHub repo. We'll go ahead and click save and we'll continue. With this part complete, we are done in Dynamo for this example, so we will go ahead and navigate to a software called Power BI. In Power BI, we'll go ahead and skip this splash screen and we'll click on Import Data from Excel. We simply need to select our recently created Excel file that has the thumbnails mapped on that last column. We'll click on Open. With that open, we need to pick a sheet to load data from. In the case of this generative design example, the sheet's name is Data. And as you can see, we have a whole lot of data in this Excel file. We'll go ahead and click on Load, and it will attach Power BI to that Excel file. It doesn't look like anything happened quite yet, but the data is loaded. At any point, if you want to verify what your data is, you can navigate to the left-hand side of the Power BI screen and to this data portion. Let's go ahead and select that now. As you can see, here's all the data from Excel. This area of Power BI is really important because we're able to do things like select data and specify how it should be interpreted in Power BI. In the case of our thumbnails, we need to select the data category as an image URL. This is important because this allows us to create visualizations and relate those to the images of the thumbnails that we exported. That's one important point to remember within Power BI. We can go ahead and navigate back to our report to start visualizing our data. In order to replicate what we see on the generative primer of this Pareto front with plotted points, we will go ahead and select the scatter chart. By selecting scatter chart in the visualizations panel, we automatically place a chart. At this point, there is no data associated with this, so we are going to go ahead and navigate to the fields panel. The data that we want to include is the floor area and the surface area. At this point, it's only showing one point on our screen, a little bit frustrating, and it's a really big number. This is because by default, Power BI is summing all of that data. If we simply select the data on the x-axis and select Don't Summarize, and we'll do the same thing for the y-axis, we will start to see something that makes a little more sense. At this point, this is a valid visualization. We're seeing all of the runs that we generated and the various plotted points that represent runs within generative design. But this doesn't tell the full story. What we want to do is start to visualize how generative design is working. In this case, we have a legend available to us. We want to group these in some way. A really great way to do this is to use the generation created parameter from generative design. Dragging that onto the legend automatically creates a visualization that is way more dynamic. At this point, you can start to really see how generative design works to optimize criteria. The blue dots represent generation 1 of the algorithm. That was the first time that it tried to optimize for your criteria. Those points are further spread out. As it works down the generation, you will see it start to get tighter and a little more efficient. At this point, if we select this green dot, we can isolate and start to see which criteria works really well. And this really provides a great way to see how generative design thinks, if you will. At this point, this is another great way to visualize data. Another great way to add some visualization to this is to select this table object. This table object can read all sorts of values and render them for us. You can also move these visualizations around as well. In this case, I'll make it a little bit larger, and I will tie the thumbnails parameter into this visualization. What's really cool about this is as I select generations, it will filter down to those generations. So you will see the ones that are selected are starting to highlight. So really quickly, we can start to filter that data, and these visualizations are tied together, which is very cool. These are grouped by generation, so if you pick on this top header, it will pick several. But if you select individual dots, it will pick that individual study. This thumbnail is a little small, so if we were to navigate to the format button on the visualization, we can go in and actually change the image height. So under grid, we can scroll down and max it out to 150. Unfortunately, in Power BI, the max image height is 150. So now as we select individual points, we will see the run that corresponds to it, and selecting generations at the top header will select that whole generation. This is very cool to be able to start to see these things. Additional pieces of data that are available to us are things like, is the solution optimal? So if you wanted to start to see which ones were optimal versus not, you can drag that into the legend. In this case, dark blue were optimal solutions. This also matches the 10th generation. The light blue are not optimal, as you can see, as they're more spread out. We'll go ahead and revert back to generation created. So there you have it. There's a way to visualize how generative design is working. So in the case of all of this massing, we can start to break down how that algorithm is solving for your criteria that you specified. I encourage you to take this example, expand upon it further by adding other visualizations, and maybe try a few of your own examples.